Now, in the previous lecture, I talked about how we can actually mathematically represent the whole concept of smoothing applied to images. We looked at a specific instance of being able to smooth an image with a kernel. You may recall that in that lecture, we looked at how we can actually mathematically represent this process of taking a kernel and applying it to a small region, a 3x3 one in this sample image. While this was for just doing the averaging, we can also do this in general terms for any kind of an image. And we came up with a term or a mathematical formulation, which basically now lets you loop over the whole image, but also provide non-uniform weights to each and every one of them to be able to create a general equation of how we can do any kind of filtering. In the last lecture, I referred to this term or this process as cross-correlation, which was an attempt to basically loop over an image or as part of an image in this instance and expand this over the whole image with a kernel, which basically was now trying to change and put non-uniform weights to be able to impact the output image. And again, we would loop over the entire image this way. Now we want to actually start looking at this whole concept of cross-correlation a little bit more in detail.